Hi everybody, welcome to Mike's Classic Auto World. Today's road trip brings us back to my friend Scott's garage. We're going to take a closer look at this 1957 Mercury Turnpike Cruiser. This is an amazing car. I think you're going to enjoy it. Scott, thank you for inviting us to your garage again.
Yep, you bet.
Again, this is a 57 Mercury Turnpike Cruiser, and it is a crazy, crazy car. You do the quick walk around. Across the front here, it's black. It has a black, white, and red interior. It's just an over-the-top type of a car. It's got the quad headlights and these parking lights are above them.
Yeah, it's the first production car to have the quad headlights.
Okay.
1957.
57?
There was a couple states that was still illegal to have quad.
Really?
Headlights, yeah.
I see the big M there for Mercury.
Gold anodized M.
Yeah. And that's a pretty unique looking grill. I just noticed these bars on either side. That's different. I guess that's unique to the Mercury.
Correct, yeah. And the hood ornament is kind of interesting too.
Yeah, it's like a gun sight.
The Mercury Knight in it.
Yeah, with the Mercury emblem. Look at that. That's pretty cool. Let me do a walk around this side here real quick. Let me get this camera right. It's a long car. It's very long. It's got these really neat Mercury wheel covers. It's got like an amber trim to it on the inside there with the Mercury shield. You don't really notice that amber color.
No, you don't. You have to really look for it.
Yeah. And it's got these raised areas, these like bullet things. It's pretty neat. It's got the spotlight on one side and side view mirror on the other. This antenna I never noticed was on such a strong rake back. It's pretty neat. And Scott was showing me these vents.
Yeah.
And they're actually functional, aren't they?
Yeah, they're kind of Jetson style, to say the least.
Yeah.
This part is non-functional. That's just for aesthetics. But there are controls inside that allow you to open the vent, and it will take air in. But aesthetically, it's really cool because they have this raised area here.
Yeah.
That kind of lines up with the antenna.
Yeah, just so for design. It's just
unbelievable, isn't it?
Yeah.
And then if you kind of look across the windshield, they stick out of the windshield.
Yeah, they do a lot.
It's incredible.
I guess it catches a lot of air by sticking out like that.
It does. I drove it yesterday and gave it a try, and I was impressed.
This vented looking area, that's just for a show?
Correct.
It's not actual functioning vents?
Correct.
I guess with these side vents, you don't need anything more in the middle.
Right. Well, when you have those open and then the back breezeway window
opens
all the way, you feel like you're in more than a convertible.
Yeah.
Without a windshield.
Yeah, we're gonna look at that breezeway window in the back. You can see that Turnpike Cruiser. Look at that. It's pretty cool. And it's got this gold anodized trim along the side, mm-hmm. and at the bottom of the C-pillar there. Really nice. Big long skirts. This is a really long car. It's deceivingly long. And Scott's got the Continental kit on the back of this. This was a dealer installed, you said?
Yes, correct. You purchased the car, and then when it arrived at the dealership, you could purchase.
So they were available, I guess, when you ordered the car.
Quite a few of these that have the Continental kit on it.
Yeah, look at that Turnpike Cruiser. It's pretty cool. And this is the little cover, I guess, for the light for your license plate.
Yep.
These lenses back here are just reflectors. Is that correct?
Correct, yep.
And the only thing that lights up back here is your tail lights up here.
And reverse light.
Reverse light. And Scott also mentioned this has a
trunk ornament.
A trunk ornament that you said that lights up?
Yeah, it lights up. Yep.
How crazy is that?
Yeah.
That is crazy. And Scott was also pointing out the body lines on this, the trunk here. You see these raised areas? They
right here, yeah.
They correspond to the trim in the back seat and flows on the trim in the back of the front seat. And that's carried onto the top of the roof as well. You can see those the body lines on top of the roof? Just little things like that that they were trying to incorporate into the styling.
Very cool.
It's very cool. Of course, we've got this stainless trim, is that,
yeah,
Scott?
Yeah.
It's got like a washboard effect to it.
Yeah. Kind of cool how the mufflers stick out at the...
Oh, yeah, corner. I didn't even notice that. Look at that.
And they designed the bumper around it.
Yeah. Look at the back of this. It's just crazy, the styling. And that Continental kit, it sticks out a good foot, at least, probably a foot and a half on top of the overall length.
For sure.
And it's got those cruiser style skirts. Look how long they are from the front of the back wheel all the way to the back of the quarter panel. Those are long skirts.
Yes, it is.
And here we got again Mercury. And Scott, this is the breezeway window you were telling us about?
Yes, it goes up and down. And
the center port?
Yeah,
the center port, rather?
We can make it go up and down for the video.
Yeah, we can
People
look at that.
Probably find it interesting.
It's a little different from the Mercury that came a little bit later and the Continental, where the breezeway was kind of angled the opposite direction.
Yeah, on the Continental Mark V, 1960, it comes back like this. And
yeah.
The breezeway window goes down like that instead of like this.
And it's kind of recessed into almost like a visor. Like the rounded, the window rounds over and kind of recesses into the roof line.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Like there's a visor.
It allows room for a speaker, which in the 60
okay.
Continental and 50.
Is that what that is, a speaker back
yeah,
there?
Yeah, a big speaker.
I'm not sure if you could see that. There's a little bit of a glare.
Yeah,
but there's actually a speaker back there behind the seat on the package tray area. It's pretty cool. And again, Turnpike Cruiser. And it's got the cover for the lock. That's pretty cool.
Goes up and down.
Look at that.
It's pretty cool.
It's very cool. Can you open it up, Scott?
Yeah,
we'll take a quick look at it.
Yeah.
Now, Scott was showing me some of the features of this car. And I got to be honest with you. This is just too much for me to remember and point out for you. So, Scott, if you, would you mind getting in there?
I'll and jump just, on the other side.
Yeah, okay.
Jump in here.
Oh, you can jump in there.
Okay.
And just point out some of the craziness of this dashboard.
So I guess we'll start from the left.
Okay.
The breezeway window, which is this
That's
control
the
here. Yep. I don't know if I need to have it on. Probably have to have it on.
Okay.
I have to have it running. Has the breezeway window in the back. And then push button transmission.
Okay.
And push start.
Okay. Push start?
Yep. Push start. Yep. Just like a lot of the new cars today have. This is a tach. And... even now in 57, you can see it's rubber.
Yeah.
They were considering people being in an accident and trying to protect them from a collision. So, and then on this side, it has a trip computer to it for what you would call a computer back then, and then also a clock. And then you have more air vents, one here, they come down.
Okay.
Or go up.
They're like toggle switches.
Yeah, and there are vents underneath the floor, which I had these on yesterday when I was driving, plus the vents that we were just talking about.
Oh, up top, yeah. These are crazy up here.
So you can go to off or on, and then there's controls of how you want it to go up and down on you.
That is nuts. So, I'm surprised that didn't really take off back in the day. Yeah. That seems like it's probably the best place for a vent.
Mm-hmm.
I'm surprised more people, more manufacturers didn't pick up on that.
So if you kind of look at how far this is raked forward
yeah.
through the glass, and then you can see the vent. I don't know if you can see
it. Yeah, it protrudes out.
Protrudes out with the ornamental antenna.
Yeah.
And then a really crazy thing is the seat adjuster, which is really cool too. You can adjust the seat for any setting you want, and then it will remember where your adjustment was when you get in and push button start the car. It'll adjust it back.
It's like a memory seat.
Yep, yep. And the really unique thing too is that when you get out, it goes all the way back so that you can get out of the car very easily.
Wow.
And then if you look, see how the steering wheel is kind of flat at the top?
Yeah.
And more round on the bottom? That was so that you had better sight line.
Yeah, so, kind of like what Mopar did.
Yep. And then the mirrors you talked about, they're adjustable from in here for the mirror, but then it's also an extra headlight.
It's a spotlight or a headlight on the other side.
It's supposed to go 1,000 linear feet. And there's two of them, so one on each side.
Whatever that is. However far that is.
And then if you kind of look across, there's automatic locks on all the doors.
Okay, is that what that is?
Yeah. So that's pretty unique.
That's pretty cool, and yeah.
These are actually the door opener and door closer. They were used on this car before the Continental started using them.
Okay, yeah, they do look like...
58, 59, and 60 Continentals.
Yeah, they do look like they were taken from the Continental.
Yeah, so a lot of this... stuff in this car, the items in this car, were pushed towards some of the...
There's the lock.
Upscaled cars.
See, the lock goes forward and back to actuate. See, that says open. Wow. This is pretty neat.
And the glove box is very strange. It's up in the middle of the dashboard. So, which
look
is
at that.
Very interesting. And then your Town and Country radio and ashtray.
Let me go around the other side.
Sure.
I'm going to go around the other side if you stay there. Get a better look at that dash. There's a lot going on in that dash. All right. Yeah. Show us that glove box again.
Oh,
the
sure.
switch is at the bottom there.
Yeah, it's at the bottom. And
look at that.
It's in the middle. You would think it's over here.
Yeah.
There's nothing there. Except
for
the speaker.
It's nice and padded.
Yes, yeah, exactly. It's very well padded. And the speedometer just kind of slides across the bottom.
Okay.
And
it's like a thermometer style?
Yeah, exactly. And I thought the numbers are very interesting, how the first digit is much larger than the zero.
Okay, yeah.
And then your fuel.
Okay.
And your temperature. And your thermostat. And this is for your heat. There's no air conditioning in this car.
Okay.
Interior lights. I forget what that one is. This is your windshield wiper.
On the
with
left?
A pump, yep. And in, exterior lights. And then we talked about the push-button transmission and the parking brake. You can release it here.
Yeah.
Or you can release it here. So
it has a very unusual setup for the push-button. You've got that long button on the right.
Yep,
which
right, yeah.
You said kind of clears the gears.
Yep, clears it all. Kind of puts you
kinda
back.
Throws
to
it in neutral.
Yep, exactly.
Okay, and then you have a release underneath it.
Yep, that, for the hood release. Yeah,
hood release, and then that release underneath the buttons themselves. That's for the parking brake. Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's correct. So very unique.
Look at the glass center.
Yeah, isn't that cool? Again,
look
at the little knight.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
And this is the power seats, which Scott was talking about.
Yeah, power memory seats.
Now, correct me, you were saying the ABCDE was for forward and back positions?
Up and down.
Up and down positions.
Yep. And the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is what spot you want the seat to be forward or backwards at.
So you would set that,
mm-hmm.
and then when you start the car, it would go to that position?
Exactly.
When you turn the car off, it would go back all the way to the back position?
Yep, it goes all the way back when you get out of the car, and it's all the way back when you get in the car, which makes it easy to get in. And as soon as you turn your
ignition
on, then the seat will automatically go to the position.
It's like an early memory seat.
It's exactly what it is. And it's so funny, 1957, the Cadillac Brougham had them on the door. But that's what this car was up with at that point. It's amazing.
Yeah, they were all trying to be upscale, shooting for that upscale market.
And if you pan to the back, it's very impressive back there, too.
Let me look back there.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's very cool.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to hold my seat with your shoulder.
Okay. Yeah, I see the light in the back is almost like a theater light. It looks like a theater light back here.
So you have the gold anodized backing, and then the Turnpike cruiser. And then this kind of opera house light look to it.
That's amazing.
And the sound system that's in the car is amazing. There's a front, two front speakers and a back speaker. And it's nice because this breezeway window goes down in that direction, so they could put one in. But, and the amount of chrome in here is just incredible.
Yeah.
And with the Mylar, you know,
strip.
Stripping. Yeah. It's really cool with the tricolor.
So let me try to zoom in on that.
Yeah. You see that Mylar, that right seam in the middle? Yeah.
Yep.
It's reflective.
Yeah.
And you got an emblem there. What is it? Is that the Mercury emblem?
Yeah, it says Turnpike Cruiser.
Wow. And there's that speaker back there that's a little easier to see now.
Yeah, can you imagine driving down the turnpike, floating down the road in this thing?
Yeah. You are definitely turnpike cruising.
Yeah, exactly.
Headliner looks really nice.
Yeah, it's really cool with that.
With the chrome bars.
Yep. I think there's as much chrome in the inside of this car as some of the classics in the 60s had on the outside.
Yeah.
It's unreal.
There's a lot going on with this car. They're definitely trying to get your attention.
Oh, and the seats over there too, the anodized gold.
Oh, yeah.
Side there.
Yeah, see this anodized gold trim, the design? It carries over to the outside. So that little feature carries along the back of the quarter panel here. They incorporated it into the interior. How cool is that?
Yeah, and the tricolor interior is really unique as well.
It is. Again, you can see the body line on the roof there that Scott was pointing out. It carries along to the trunk. That's pretty cool. Again, those vents. One crazy thing about this car is I always worry about this post here getting in and out. A lot of people, I'm sure, banged into that.
Yeah, for sure.
That only lasted a few years.
Maybe that's why they want the back seat to go all the way back when you get in.
Yeah, you're probably right. Yeah, give them as much room as possible getting in this thing.
For sure.
Again, look at that door panel. And this car is absolutely perfect. The material is spot on.
This is like a washboard
material
down here. And it rakes through in the back, too. It's pretty cool. It carries through.
The door jams are perfect, just as shiny and clean as the outside of the car.
Yeah, and they used all leather.
It's all leather?
Yeah, all leather, including all in the upholstery of the seats.
Cool. Yeah. There's the back seat, the back of the front seat, rather. And there's that Mylar trim, which is reflective. That's pretty neat.
Yeah, and this pattern here, right, with the stripes in it, is the same as the pattern on the top of the back of the seat.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
To follow that dip in the trunk, right,
that
to follow all the way through.
Is the same as right there.
Definitely a lot of design thought.
Yeah. This is really a special car. Can you open the trunk?
Sure, yep.
This Continental kit is a really neat feature.
Be a little while to figure it out.
Yeah, I see a pull handle here on the right side. I'm sure that's how you're going to lift it up and over.
And the crazy thing is every time you gassed up a car,
you got to deal with that?
You had to do this.
Look at that. You pull the handle up and it unlatches it. You can see the handle back there.
Yeah.
It's crazy. And it just flips over, up and over.
Cool thing about the trunk. Has that knight again on it, which follows through the whole car, right?
I see that, yeah.
Hubcaps, emblems, hood ornament, trunk ornament, but that flips up too. Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
See if I got the right key here. There we go.
Wow, look at that.
Big trunk.
Very big trunk, and you got the side panels, which look beautiful. Look at that. Look how clean that is. Tire's never been down. And you got access to the gas. Where's the gas cap?
Yeah, gas is in here.
Wow, you do have to move that tire out of the way, don't you?
Yeah, there's no other way.
Look how clean that is. That tire's beautiful. Is that bias ply?
Yep. Same as the rest of the tire.
Same as the rest.
And look at this emblem even, too.
Oh, yeah.
How cool that looks.
Look at that.
Just unbelievable. And again,
the
it flips
there.
Up, right?
Is that the coolest thing or what?
Yeah, it's really cool.
You know,
the gold anodized behind
it. Yeah, you don't get that in today's cars.
That's for sure.
I mean, they were really fighting for their audience when they designed this thing. You know? They wanted to stick out from the crowd for sure.
Yeah, I think they were all trying to outdo each other.
They were. They were. And I'm a sucker for all the doodads and the bells and whistles and everything. And this car has a ton of bells and whistles. Now that snaps in place, or do you have to?
So it goes down and then goes, it just kind of secures itself.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's amazing, isn't it? It's huge.
It is big.
And heavy.
There's not an actual tire in there, I guess, right?
There is.
Oh, there is,
yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Is there a wheel to it, or is it just the tire?
Rim and tire.
Oh, okay.
So you have two spares.
Two spares, yeah.
Right, one in the trunk.
Yeah, you see a Continental kit, you don't realize that, or you wonder if it's a dummy kit or what, but it actually has a tire in there.
I think at least this car. I would have used the trunk one instead of this one. It's a lot less.
Yeah, work. I think you're right.
Unless you're unlucky enough going down the turnpike to get two flats.
Yeah. Hopefully that'll never happen.
But yeah, this window in the back is really cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, even how that's all curved.
Yeah, the way it's rounded and it recesses into the roof line.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a 50s dream car design that they actually put into production. Yeah.
Like a concept car.
Like a concept car, exactly. Yeah. You could see the other side, how it's recessed into the roof.
And again, they used a lot of these items on the 58, 59, and 60 Continental.
Yes.
So the Turnpike Mercury Cruiser had a lot of stuff that the Continentals did not have yet in 57.
And just for you guys at home, Scott happens to have a 60 Continental.
Yes.
Mark V, is it?
Yes, that's correct. Yeah.
And I have a video of that car. You have to check that one out. That car is crazy over the top. It's just as crazy as this car. Scott has an amazing collection of cars.
Thank you.
He's going to open the hood here. Now, school me on this. This is a 3-something or other, right?
It's a 368, 290 horsepower.
There you go.
So, again, similar to the Continental engine.
Well, look how they did the, is this for the air intake?
Yes. At a certain point, when the air is to a certain temperature, there's a door inside here.
Okay.
That shuts or opens to allow different temperature air to get to the carburetor, which makes it run better.
Yeah. So,
but the really cool thing is if you come on the other side.
Sure.
Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
Is that unique? Or
look at that Turnpike Cruiser.
Yeah.
I noticed it's kind of like an engine turn finish. The dashboard has an engine turn finish.
It's the exact same finish as
the
finish. Isn't that cool? Or very close to it.
And they only put it on one side because of the intake on the other.
I guess, yeah. Yep.
And you've got the orange fan.
Yeah.
Pulley.
Yep. And these are the original colors. This is what it would have looked like when you got it from the factory.
So it's got the proper stampings.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Where they're supposed to be. The hood pad looks nice. Everything is really clean in here and just right. This is a neat car. Look how they did the wiring. You know?
It's a big engine.
Yeah. It is.
You needed something large to pull the weight of this.
And the wipers, they go back and forth from the outer end of the windshield, and they meet in the center. Pontiac did that, I think, in the 60s. I always thought that was neat, where they open from the outside, they go up and down from the outside.
Yeah, I think it makes the visibility better.
Do you?
Maybe.
I've never driven in one where they work that way.
Yeah.
But I always thought it was neat.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if it was better for use or just a styling thing or what, but I always thought it was neat when they opened from that way.
I guess, right?
Yeah, let me take another look at this crazy interior. This is an amazing car. I like this one. Scott's got a big collection. This is one of his newest cars that he's added to his collection. You guys at home, please subscribe to my channel. I'm always bringing unique vehicles to the channel. And, leave your comments. Let me hear your stories, your opinions. Like the video if you like the video, but definitely subscribe and stay tuned for more fantastic videos. Scott, thank you very much for showing us this car. It's amazing.
Thank you, Mike.
And stay tuned to the channel. We'll see you soon.